What's up, BC? This is a contest video for my friend Jeff Kempin. Jeff, man, this is your 500 subs contest. Yeah, I think I got that right. And I put another R word in front of it, Royal Riptastic. I was trying to think of this long iteration of words, but I just didn't have the brain power today. I'm fighting allergies today. It's kind of crazy weather here, crazy being pretty warm here in Florida. And yesterday I mowed the backyard for the first time. It should have been like the third or fourth time. So you can only imagine what jungle it was there. And oh my gosh, I haven't been feeling that great ever since. It was last night and now tonight. And so I'm trying to fight through the allergies that's going on in my brain right now. Jeff, congratulations, man, first and foremost. And thank you for your friendship. You are an awesome, awesome guy. I sent, and then you sent, you know, we shared VCLT together. We've been in contact with each other for a little over a year now, maybe almost a year and a half. Yeah, you just are a stand-up, amazing, cool guy, and thank you for your friendship, bro. This contest is five songs, there we go, that have riff-tastic, not rip-tastic, riff-tastic. I can't say that word. I love the fact that I called it a word. I couldn't come up with just five. And so I came up with five genres with two albums or two songs each. And I really had difficulty with this one, Jeff, because a riff to me is anything that pulls you into a song. To me, it can be a guitar. It could be a wind instrument, like brass or wind instrument. It can be a bass. I guess technically that's a guitar. It can be a sample from like hip hop or trip hop. And there are just far too many to choose from. And yeah, so four of these, I am going to show video clips of them doing a live set. Four of these songs I'm going to do videos for. Just kind of freshen it up a little. And so the first two I'll show videos, and then the last two I'll do videos as well. So the first one, of course, you know I've got to cover desert rock. And I'd almost say forgive me. I'm not gonna. I've got to mention Hami in this. And actually, for both of Desert Rock, they're both Hami, except for one isn't Queens of the Stone Age, and this one is Them Crooked Vultures. If you haven't heard this album, listen to this album. This album is phenomenal. Sorry, I thought I heard Bato. Nah, maybe not. My mind's going crazy. Anyway, Them Crooked Vultures, the only album by them. This album has David Grohl on drums and vocals. It has Josh Homme on lead and lead vocals. And then it has John Paul Jones on bass and vocals. The three of them. And I played a song off of this, and I'm just going to continue with that song. That same song, and that's Scumbag Blues, but I'm going to play the live version that they did in, I think it was France? I don't know. It might have been a Spanish country, too. I don't know. This video just makes me so happy, almost in tears so happy. Just the way that it starts off with the bass riff. John Paul Jones just starts the bass riff, then kicks it into a bass solo, which then kicks it into the guitar riff from Hami, and then that changes into a guitar solo. Yeah, there we go, guitar solo. And then, while the guitar solo kicks in, the organ riff comes in, and that organ riff is done by Mr. Alan Johannes, who also toured with them. This album came out in 2009, November of 2009, and so they were on tour for 2009, part of 2009, 2010, and maybe 2011. I'm hoping for another album by them. This is a tremendous, tremendous album. But Scumbag Blues is the name of that song. And I mentioned that it almost brings me the tears out of happiness, just the way they are able to jam with each other. And the crowd is just going crazy for this song. And it's just so much fun to see. And really, I wished I was there. I think life would have been really, really good if I was there. This is going to be a long clip. I mean, it's got a bass solo, guitar solo in it, and so I think it's about 2.5 minutes long. But I really am deeming a lot of these videos as a friend just showing you, you know, a good friend is showing you really, really good music and just kind of sharing these videos with you, because I don't have very many people to show this stuff to. Anyway, let's get into it. Apologize for the poor video quality, because it really is shoddy quality, but here is that needle drop. No, here is that video. Telling you, that looked like a fantastic concert, and I wish I was there. I really wish I was there. So the next one is Desert Rock again, and this is off of The Queens of the Stone Age. This is their 2002 album, Songs for the Deaf. And I've played two iterations of this song that I'll play, which is You Don't Think I'm Worth a Dollar, But I Feel Like a Millionaire. And we got this one off the album, which fares Nick Oliveri on vocals. He was the bassist from, gosh, when was that? I think he started in 99, maybe 2000, somewhere around there. And then he was off the band in 2004. I think the reason was, though Hami has never said this, was that Nick Oliveri was, in some sort of a drunken or in enraged stupor, that he actually beat his, I think it was girlfriend or wife, and Hami was like, yeah, we're not having any part of that, and kicked him out of the band. He is still friends with Nick, and so the last time that I heard him talk about this, he's like, hey, he wanted to go one direction, I wanted to go another direction, and I mean, I founded the band, and my rule won. So I think that was a much more PR move, because they are still friends and everything. But a lot of people, when Nick left, hated Queens of the Stone Age. I love it. I think Queens of the Stone Age has kind of evolved over the years, and I'll listen to this version. The last one I listened to, the last time I played this song, it was on that Desert Sessions, and it sounded like pro wrestlers. They were trying to work out all the, I think they were doing that one to work out the kinks for this album. But now, since Nick isn't in the band anymore, you've got Hami singing lead. I'm not sure why the bassist, Mikey Shoes, doesn't sing, because he screams parts. So, I mean, I think he would do a pretty good job. Granted, he doesn't have Nick's voice, but I think he could still do a pretty good job. But Hami brings this kind of Elvis tone to it, and yeah, I still like it. As much as I don't care for Elvis, I still like what Hami brings to the table. And this this video I'm going to show, I'm going to put this down. It kind of starts out a little crazy with Spider-Man, a guy dressed up in Spider-Man. I'm thinking that this is in Brazil or something. Spanish people are crazy. Hispanic people are crazy. There we go. And so he's full dressed in Spider-Man, and he gets invited to on the stage by Hami. He's like, hey, come here. And so he crowd surfs the entire way and comes up on stage and everything in front of Hami. And Hami can get kind of evil with people joining him on stage. I think this was back in 2002, 2003. He shoved someone off the stage that just came on the stage. He was not having it, and he was like, this is my effing stage. He didn't do that this time. He invited him on, but there was a time where he's like, no, you need to get off the stage right now. So he calmed himself. I think this video was back in 2018. So, I mean, he's still gotten in trouble in 2018 for, you know, kicking a camera and that hit a woman in the face and everything like that. Anyway, rock stars, right? So this song, what I love about it is the engine portion of it, the sound of this V8 engine just running in the background, and you've got the bass riff and the guitar riff, and the guitar riff just, man, it just continually goes forward, you know, and it just keeps moving the song forward, and it continues to move me in. I kid you not, I watch this video probably four or five times a month. It's that good. I'm going to even leave it in a link of, in the description. Now, there's swearing in there, so everyone just be warned. It might not be fully safe for work or little ears, but it's definitely a really cool song by Queens of Stone Age. This is probably about a minute long, so just sit back and enjoy. Here it is. The next two are hip hop, and this is a group that I really love. I fell in love with them, then out of love with them, and then now back into love with them, and probably not going away anytime soon. And this is Public Enemy. This is their fourth album. I'm trying not to start over on this one. I'm used to doing like 20 takes per take. And we're just going to keep going. We're doing this Jeff style. I'm not saying that you do bad. You do really good, Jeff. You're really good at this compared to me. I would start over right there. Fourth album. There we go. Apocalypse 91, The Enemy Strikes Black. And released in 1991. I, for some reason, thought that this was released in 1990, but no. Fear of a Dark Planet, Black Planet, there we go, Fear of a Black Planet, my head, was released in 1990, but 1989, another summer, was actually for a soundtrack, and that's why they said 89 on a 90 album. Song off this, let's stop talking. Can't Trust It. This is my favorite song off this album. Still quite possibly my favorite song off of this album. And what really pulled me in for this was the trumpet riff in the background that plays throughout the entire song. I tried to do my homework. It's normally not me doing these videos. And I tried to look up that sample. And I found that they sampled like 19 songs in this song, ranging from Eric B. and Rakim to James Brown to, is Herbie Hancock in there? I don't think so. Sly, was it Sly Brothers? I don't know. Andrew, Tales from the Crate. Showed their the album in, I think, his last video, his latest video. The trumpet, Tim or Esteban would be able to give me some lessons in that sample, because they're so much better at samples than I am. I didn't even know where the Peter Piper Run DMC sample came from until Esteban's video. I knew it was a jazz album, but those bells, man, those bells. I need to get that album. So I'll just play 30 seconds off of this album, off of the song Can't Trust It. It's such a good song. I love Chuck D's voice, and man, I love that horn in the background, and so here is that riff on the song.
Here come the drums! Here come the drums!
to the woods. So the people give you some of that reacting to the facts that I kick in a stick in a stay around point to the joint. Put the booty down.
Continuing with hip hop, and this one was difficult because I was planning on doing something from Beastie Boys, and the album I was gonna pull was Paul's Boutique. I really like that. I really like Shake Your Rump song, but they had that rawr, that buzzing sound in there that they scratched and whatnot. And I always thought that was a really good riff that pulled me in. I don't have that album in my collection, so kind of difficult to show. I don't even think I have the CD. How do I listen to it? Spotify? Must be. I think I ripped the CD from a friend way back in the day, and that's what I listened to. So this was a last minute grab, and this is off of Cypress Hill's debut album. What song am I going to play? I mean, the first few songs are... this whole album is wonderful. The first few songs are really good. You've got that Duke of Earl sample that just repeats the Duke of Duke. Didn't choose to pull that one. What I did choose to do was the bass riff at the beginning of my favorite song, Real Estate. And great song by them. Don't even attempt to get their new album. It's horrible. Whatever happened to you guys? Whatever happened to you guys? First two albums, great. Third album, everything after that. It's on red vinyl, just so you see it on the turntables. Yeah, anyway, everything has to be colored vinyl, man. This is their 91 album. And debut, great song, Real Estate, and here it is. Another bass riff, but this time it's in electronic music. Yes, electronic music does have bass riffs. And this is from one of my favorite groups, the Chemical Brothers. Their debut album. A lot of debut albums in this video. This released in 1995. I bought this in, the day after I learned about the Chemical Brothers. I bought this probably, I think early 97, and was living in Oklahoma at the time, drove out to Tulsa, Oklahoma, bought this at Mohawk Music for $13.98. It goes for a whole lot more than this now. Thankfully, they've recently been reissued, I think 1,400 copies, and every record store I've been in that carries Chemical Brothers has a good amount of these, so they aren't going very fast, I guess. It's been 2 years since it's been reissued. This album, back in all the way up to maybe 98, 99, 2000, even, I loved this entire album. And now I look at it, and the first few songs, which I think the song I'll be playing is the second, the first few songs are amazing, absolutely amazing. But as the album goes further on, I think I over listened to it back in the day, and it just doesn't stand up to the first three or four songs of this on this album. So the song that I'll be playing is In Dust We Trust, and that is that bass riff at the beginning. Really great, fuzzy, raw bass riff that just pulls you in at the beginning and keeps going till the end of the song. It's just really good. And so here is In Dust We Trust by the Chemical Brothers. along the same vein in the electronic space is The Prodigy. This, I don't know what number the album this is. This is like number five, number six. I don't know. I don't look any of this stuff up. I'm just gonna hit record. This is their 2008 album. This is Invaders Must Die. Oh gosh. This is a tremendous album. I do like this album through and through. Took a little time to get, you know, like all of the songs on this, but the riff on this, it's not another bass riff. It's more of a, almost like a trumpet. Yeah, trumpet riff. It's almost like a bandstand type of riff. I don't know. Really, really like it. The song is called Stand Up. It's the last song on this album, and it's very breakbeat intense. So is Chemical Brothers. Breakbeat, big beat, and kind of hold Chemical Brothers and The Prodigy kind of in the same vein, especially the Chemical Brothers' earlier work. It really, really good. I like this cover. I almost never remember what this cover is, but it's like a Zeppelin that's being, you know, and I saw this is the bad thing about the labels that I do. Some of them get caught on other things and rip and everything. I'm like, oh, when did that happen? So anyway, Stand Up, my mind is everywhere today. Stand Up by The Prodigy, and here is that big beat / jazzy type trumpet riff for you. Trip hop, and Jeff, I know you just picked up this album just a few weeks ago, and that is Dummy by Portishead, their debut album. A lot of debuts. 2004, I almost said 2005, but 2004. This is a reissue. I don't know. I got this. Oh, this is a 2008 reissue. Go me. Man, that's probably one of the first ones that I actually looked up. I think I recorded put all the information in sometime in 2016. Pretty good reissue of this album, and the song that I'll be playing is Strangers. Strangers, yes. And bass riff, and got that organ riff in there as well, kind of mirror together, and then you have that guitar solo that kind of carries it on. Just such a good song, and that's all the introduction I'm going to do. Here is that needle drop. Moving on with more trip hop, and that is DJ Shadow. Some would probably differ that DJ Shadow is trip hop. I think he is. He's electronic, he's hip hop, and he's got some trip hop elements. So I just put him in trip hop. This is his 2002 album, The Private Press. my favorite album by him. This is his third album. Maybe second album, because that second album that I thought was a full album is a compilation, I think. I think this might be his second album. I got ruined by Tim when he said that. I'm like, wait, what? Yeah, no, that's what Discogs says. song on this that I'll play is Walkie Talkie. In the riff that I'm putting in, a lot of samples. It's DJ Shadow. He's kind of the king of samples. That song has that kind of a buzz. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's a sample. I don't know if it's just a sound effect from like an organ or a keyboard. But it's this ah ah. It almost sounds like a semi horn. That as crazy as it sounds, that draws me in. And just the way he uses it is absolutely incredible. And so here is that song with that sample. Albums left, one genre left, and this is psych rock, garage rock. Both of these albums fill both of them. And we're gonna play one of my favorite songs from DOCs. I played this song off the album before, and that is Sticky Hulks. Guitar riff slash solo. I'm not gonna play it from the album, though. I'm gonna show how crazy John Dwyer is, and so I'm gonna play some off of a live video with KEXP. I'll put that link in the description as well. These videos are all a lot of fun. I really enjoy the videos that are on YouTube with these bands. And so this is off of their, I don't know what number album this is, but this is off their 2015 album, Mutilator Defeated at Last. And this is a great, great album. And Sticky Hulks. Is it Sticky Hulks or Sticky Hulk? It's on the other side. When I look. Hulks. That's what I wrote. Hope I wrote it down right. Yes, Hulks. Anyway, here is that video of this song.
Thank you.
last one, Psych / Garage Rock as well, and this is the first album by this group that I've gotten, and I've gotten probably 7 or 8 now, and this is King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard. Andy Borders is the one who said, hey, you should check this album out. This band out, check this album out as a good starter album, and this is probably still my favorite album by them. And this is Nonagon. Did I get that right? Nonagon Infinity. There we go. Nonagon Infinity. And it's an album that you start at the front, play it all the way through, and the ending goes back to the front. I don't know how you can do that on vinyl, but pretty cool idea. And then it's 9 songs, thus the Nonagon. And so, anyway. And Infinity means that it can loop it forever. That's fun. first track right off of this, Robot Stop, is my absolute favorite song by them. And it's got this, it also has kind of a engine feel to it, where it just keeps on moving forward. And their videos on YouTube, there's like 20 people in this band, and they really, really keep it moving forward. And yeah, and so I don't know any of their names, but they're all incredible. They got 2 drummers. I mean, technically, the OCs have 2 drummers as well. They only had one drummer in that video. But 2 drummers, like 3 guitarers? Anyway, harmonica player, keyboard player, pretty crazy. Bass player, probably 5 bass players, who knows. But it's the combination of it all that makes it a riff. Really. And then they have this just all the guitars, and then you got the harmonica, the mouth organ going on. That could be a riff in itself. So I don't know how much of this. I haven't really rewatched this video in probably a couple of weeks, a couple of days. So I'll probably pick out a good chunk, maybe a minute or 2 or 3. Anyway, I might just play the whole concert. Who knows? Here is Robot Stop by King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard. Jeff, those are 10 albums, 5 genres with fantastic riffs. Those albums, every single one of those albums is incredible. I highly recommend all 10 of those albums. I almost said 5. 10 of those albums. And I feel like they're a must for everyone's collection if you're trying to collect many genres. Congratulations again on the 500 subs. Way to go. way to go. And thank you so much for your friendship. I had a lot of fun with this contest, and I hope you're enjoying these contest videos. I haven't seen you in the VC for a couple of, well, I was going to say a couple of weeks, but really it's only been like 7 or 8 days. And yeah, I hope you're doing all right. Maybe you're just taking a break. I took a break from editing. I'm working on the BCLT video and thought I'd record this real quick. I like when there's sunshine out and everything like that, and many times I don't get to do videos until later in the evening when it's dark out and everything. But yeah, I don't know why I'm saying this. Again, I'm just gonna say it's my brain. Foggy and everything, just random content. Brad without a filter. So, again, thank you for your friendship, Jeff, and hope you're doing well, and staying warm this winter, and it's been a really crazy winter for everyone in the Midwest, and so, yeah, again, hope you're enjoying these videos as you're watching them, and yeah, take care, bro. You've got some VCLT coming to you pretty soon. I'll text you. You'll probably see the text before I get this video out, because I think I'm gonna buy them tomorrow. They're gonna be bought from Amazon. So yeah. Anyway, take care, brother. And yeah, I hope you're enjoying listening to Great Vinyl, and again enjoying all of these videos. And everyone else, hope you're listening to Great Vinyl as well. And we will talk to you next time.